China's insane space technology will change everything. Innovation cannot exist without ambition, and neither can a grand vision, struggle, or victory. In today's video, we are going to tell you about how China's insane space technology will change everything. Since the early days of the Cold War, leaders and innovators from powerful nations across the world have aimed to break through the final terrestrial boundary and reach for the stars. Today, 77 countries have their own space agencies, 16 have the ability to launch spacecraft, and 5, plus the Continental European Space Agency, can land on extraterrestrial bodies. However, only 3 nations have sent living human beings to space: the United States, Russia, and China. The US and Russia accomplished this during the Cold War, but China has taken a different path in the past 30 years, developing its own pioneering and technologically advanced space program, known as Project 921. China's goal of achieving human spaceflight is currently at the forefront of its global ambition, science and technology, education, and innovation. Project 921, which has been a central mission for China, has played a key role in guiding the country towards its current status as an emerging superpower. On April 24, 1970, the Dongfanghong satellite was successfully launched into orbit around Earth by China. Using domestically produced materials and a Chinese rocket, despite its limited mission of playing a patriotic song and announcing the time, the satellite was a major proof of concept for China and put them alongside the US, Soviet Union, United Kingdom, and France as the only countries to have launched anything into space at that time. The idea of placing an artificial satellite into orbit was first adopted by Mao Zedong in 1958. But it was a massive undertaking that coincided with a disastrous Great Leap Forward, resulting in the death of millions of people in China. However, it was technically feasible, and a task force led by Chinese scientist Qian Jujian, who had been educated in the United States before being expelled during the Red Scare, worked on it for the next 12 years at the Chinese Academy of Sciences. The successful launch of Dongfanghong satellite was a major achievement for China, which had faced significant obstacles and setbacks in its efforts to develop its space program. In addition to the challenges posed by the Great Leap Forward, China also faced political upheaval and international isolation during the Cultural Revolution of the late 1960s and early 1970s. Despite these challenges, China continued to invest in its space program, and by the early 21st century, it had become a major player in the global space industry. Today, China has a well-established space program that includes a range of capabilities, including the ability to launch satellites and conduct manned space flights. It has also developed its own space station, the Tiangong Space Station, which is expected to be fully operational by the end of 2022. In addition, China has plans to conduct manned missions to the moon and other planets in the coming decades, making it a major player in the global race to explore space. China's space program has continued to evolve and expand over the years, driven by a combination of scientific, economic, and geopolitical factors. In addition to its space station and manned spaceflight capabilities, China has also developed a range of space technologies, including advanced satellites, deep space exploration probes, and rocket launch vehicles. One of the key factors driving China's space program is its desire to establish itself as a global technological leader and to gain the economic and geopolitical benefits that come with that status. China's space program has also been motivated by scientific and technological curiosity, as well as by its desire to enhance its national security by developing advanced space-based surveillance and communication systems. However, China's space program has also faced criticism and scrutiny from some quarters. The United States, in particular, has expressed concern about China's space ambitions, viewing them as a potential threat to American national security and technological superiority. Some experts have also raised questions about the transparency and safety of China's space program, particularly in the wake of a number of high-profile incidents, such as the 2007 anti-satellite missile test, which created a significant amount of space debris and raised concerns about the safety of other space assets. Despite these concerns, China's space program continues to grow and expand, and it is likely to remain a major player in the global space industry for years to come. As China continues to develop new space technologies and capabilities, it will be interesting to see how other nations respond and how the international space community evolves in response to these developments. China's team of space scientists had a close association with China's nuclear weapons program, which was led by Zhu Zhen. This space program eventually developed the Long March series of rockets, similar to the United States and Soviet Russia. China's first launch vehicles were based on ballistic missiles, but they became much more advanced over time, By 1970, when China successfully launched its first satellite, its rocket scientists and engineers were already focused on putting the first human in space. Within a year, they had selected 19 astronaut candidates to train and compete for the honor. However, the Communist Party, with its sights set on an internal enemy during the years of the Cultural Revolution, which was China's intellectual class, including many of its best scientists and engineers, didn't stop its ascent. Although the space program continued for some time, the pressure of the revolution ultimately proved too much, and many of its leaders were dismissed from their posts. During the Cultural Revolution, which lasted from 1966 to 1976, Mao Zedong and the Communist Party launched a campaign to rid China of what they called counter-revolutionary elements. This campaign targeted intellectuals, artists, and other groups deemed to be potential threats to the party's power. Many of China's top scientists and engineers were among those who were persecuted during this time. The space program was not immune to the Cultural Revolution's impact, and many of its leaders were dismissed from their posts. However, the program was not completely derailed, and some key figures were able to keep it going. In particular, Qian Zhuzhen, a rocket scientist who had studied in the United States before returning to China, playing a critical role in keeping the program alive. Despite the setbacks caused by the Cultural Revolution, China continued to make progress in space technology. In 1978, it launched its first recoverable satellite, and in 1992, it sent its first astronaut into space. Since then, China has continued to develop its space program, building its own space station and sending probes to the Moon and Mars. Today, China's space program is widely regarded as a major player in the global space community. It has ambitious plans for the future, including a crewed mission to Mars and the establishment of a permanent lunar base. Although China's space program has had a complex and sometimes difficult history, it has shown remarkable resilience and continues to make impressive strides forward. The space program's trainees, who were preparing to become astronauts, were dismissed, and soon after, China's space program was almost non-existent, with the last remnants abolished in 1980. After the abandonment of its early space program in the 1970s, China rekindled its ambition for space exploration in the 1990s with the initiation of Project 921. This ambitious project aimed to put a Chinese human in space and construct a space station. The project was launched in 1992, and it had a three-phase plan. The first phase focused on launching an unmanned spacecraft and learning everything needed to put a human into space. The second phase involved sending two Chinese astronauts to learn how to conduct spacewalks, dock near their modules, and prepare for a short-term space station. The third phase involved constructing China's own space station, from which it could support a crewed mission in the long term. This project was overseen by the newly founded China National Space Administration, and China had to develop and manufacture its technology to achieve its objectives. While the Chinese space program took inspiration from Russian and American designs, it has developed its technologies and has made significant progress in space exploration, including the successful launch of a Mars mission and the ongoing construction of its space station. That's all. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe to our channel and ring the bell icon to get more videos.